The last thing that happened was I mentioned APA citations and somebody said, what's that?
I did that. I just didn't know what it was called.
Did you do it in APA format or in MLA format?
I don't know. I just don't
know what I used to
do.
That would be MLA format.
Okay.
MLA format will get you some points off. There are some small differences between MLA format and APA format, and you are going to want to know what they are, because your English teacher most likely requires MLA format. In the past, I have required MLA format.
What's that?
The shopping was an option.
I think the M is for modern. I don't know the rest of it. When you cite your resources, for a science paper, or when you put a works cited paper page into a paper for English class, they are very, very much the same. The same information is there. There's a different order. That's really about the nuts and bolts of the difference. Have you done any work at all on the internet for this project?
Yes.
Yes. Every single one of you has. Did you take things from somebody else?
No.
Yes. I would bet every single one of you has. Whether you copied and pasted, whether you quoted word for word, or whether you paraphrased, you took things from somebody else, which is completely fine, as long as you cite it. So, in APA, you should have a resources page and of a document. Computer skills class. What page is that? Page 30. Right? Page 2 of 30. Which means I'll probably click into that page. And if I move my mouse and I click into this page, it will say page 303. That was horribly complicated, was it? Word count. Viewing size. Do you work two screens at one time? Two windows at one time, proper terminology. How come this one has a producer, a date, a title, a subtitle, what it is, where it was produced, and who produced it? And this one only has a date and a title. What it is, and a country of origin. Why is there such a difference in their both documentaries? Did I do that one wrong? That's all that was available. This other information, they didn't give it to me. If the people that publish the website don't give you the information, you don't make it up. You don't include it. You're off the hook. You don't have to. But it's still the same order, isn't it? This one starts with the year. This one, the year is over there. What's supposed to be in front of the year? What's in front of the year on this? Do you know what Education Week is? It's in italics, isn't it? It's a publication. It's a magazine. What's the first thing on the magazine? Whose last name? The writer, the author. We have an author, we have a date, we have a title, we have a publication. We have a volume. And a page number. Does that make sense? It's probably series 32, volume 7, page 18. Is that all brand new stuff for have you been over that before? You've been over that, right? What's this one? Is that a book or magazine? Is that a video? That's my textbook for my class. Two authors. Title with a colon in it, and where the information came from. When I go up into the text, where are the citations in here? Do you know what these citations are called? The bottom is a resource page. In English class, that'll be a works cited page. In-text citations are parenthetical. Right? And it's the first thing in the citation below. And the page number. For a book. And because I had an author, it's the author's last name. If I didn't have an author, this might be the name of the book, or the name of the web page, or the title of the video. Do you need more help with citations? I don't know your English teacher. I don't know how much work you've done. I don't know your computer teacher. I don't know what you're able to do and what you're not. But I don't want to sit here and bore you by explaining crap you already know. And clearly, Aurora is bored. Do I need to go to the web and show you an APA citation? If you go to Bing, I started the school year at 560 something. And I now have 657 points, apparently.
You can
get
it
on the card. Yes, I can. And I got 157 points towards the second one. But if I go here and I type in...
I think you can get a score.
Purdue Owl.
Oh, I'm just saying.
And I even spelled Purdue wrong. And it still comes up. But it'll show you. Guys, I just did something that you guys do wrong all the time. When you do a search, you're not sure if this is exactly what you want. Or if you know you're going to want APA and MLA, you should right-click, open link to new tab. It'll open up over here and your search stays here. And now I can come up here, type ML and hit enter. And right-click, open link to new tab. And I have MLA right here, and I have APA right here. There's your general APA guidelines. Here's how you do in-text citations of all the different kinds. Here's how you do articles and periodicals. Tells you how to do an abstract, how to cite in APA formats, and right here, contributors' names, last edited date, title of resource, retrieve from, you need to give a web address, this is what the page you're on right here looks like. So we have a whole bunch of contributors' names, a last edited date, title of the resource, and a retrieved from. Every web page that you used in creating this product that you have for me, both the physical product and the writing and the oral presentation that you'll get next time. Every web resource you use should be done like that. Pictures came from?
Just Google Pictures.
Google doesn't have pictures. Google finds pictures that other people put on the web. That tells me something else. You can't cite this. You can't cite this. Because I know what happened. Didn't go to google.com and type in. And if you're smart, you don't even type the whole thing. And then you go to images. Then you go there. See, I got it from Google. Correct?
No, you got it from
sciencenotes.org. You got it from sciencenotes.org, and Google just found it for you. So what you actually have to do is visit page. And when you get to the page, eventually, someday, this is where you actually got that image from. This is the correct URL. When you're citing a source, very important, when you're citing a source, the correct URL never starts with google.com. It never starts with bing.com, swag, search, swag, dot. No, never. So, for this thing, you should have a resources page. For the writing that you had to do, you should have a resources page, and you should have in-text citations. Did you?
Yeah.
That's where the physical thing came from. Where did the idea to make it look like this come from? That's entirely possible. If you didn't go to the web and steal ideas for this, you don't have to be more excited for this. That's entirely possible. Don't worry about the science. Or talk with you in class. The stuff in your Word document then, your explanation, those ideas came from somewhere. I said everything that you needed so that you could do that paper. That's a shocker. There's got to be some web research in that document. If there isn't, I'm not sure your document is adequate. And I'm not sure you covered all of those ideas.
That's right.
And you should have a printout of the rubric, or at least have the rubric available on your computer to make sure that your Word document has everything in it that you need to cover. Or you can flip that around and say, if I can actually do this, I might be impressed with myself.
No, that's not what I mean.
I wonder. What do I still have? I'll research it. Just search back. Don't let me leave the room. need from me so that you can finish this product and get an A?
What?
If you need more help with citations, talk to me.
What?
I'm not exactly an expert, but I can handle it.
I'm not supposed to. Okay, what am I doing?
Spacing out, staring at traffic.
Don't look at that.